Good morning to all. As we know, in the last video we were discussed about few important problems, few very important problems. That means in the last exercise almost half of the problems we discussed, and still half is remaining, but comparatively the remaining half is simple problem. And through this video session I'm going to discuss two problems, only two problems. Please take the video as a serious lesson, and please watch it carefully. Okay, learn well. See, so now we are going to solve. See, up to this question we have discussed. Now we have to solve this question. 1 plus ek by ck is equal to, prove that 1 plus ek by ck is equal to sine square a by 1 minus cosine. And in the bracket, a hint is given, simplify LHS and RHS separately. Simplify LHS and RHS separately. So you just think that why they given as hint like that in the bracket. The problem is, in some kind of problem in trigonometry, when we solve LHS, when we simplify LHS, we cannot reach to RHS. Only in few cases, maybe when we take LHS and when we go for the simplification method, we cannot reach RHS successfully. So at that time, what we will do is, we will simplify LHS and we will simplify RHS and compare the both answers. That is the method we have to use. So that is only in the case of few problems, few special case problem. And this is a kind of problem like that. That's why they given a hint in the bracket. And don't expect this type of hints in board exam. Okay. Since it is an in-text question, they given a hint like that. And so how you can understand whether a problem we want to simplify LHS and RHS separately? Only thing is that if you simplify LHS in the right way, if you are not reaching to RHS, you just try to simplify RHS also and try to compare the both answers. See this problem, you will get understood. So this is your question. So what I'm going to do is, let me take LHS first. What is that? 1 plus CK by CK. LHS and RHS simplify ചെയ്യണമെന്ന് അങ്ങനെ പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. അപ്പം ചില കുട്ടികൾ വിചാരിക്കും, ഇനി എങ്ങനെ സാർ അത് മനസ്സിലാവും, എക്സാമിന് LHS ഉം RHS ഉം സിംപ്ലിഫൈ ചെയ്യണോ എന്നൊക്കെ. അത് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇപ്പോൾ മനസ്സിലാവും. നിങ്ങളൊന്ന് LHS-ൽ നിന്ന് തുടങ്ങി. അതായത് നമുക്ക് LHS-ൽ നിന്നുള്ള സാധാരണ സ്റ്റാർട്ട് ചെയ്യാം. ലെറ്റ് സ്റ്റാർട്ട് വിത്ത് LHS അഗെയിൻ. സോ ദിസ് ഈസ് എ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ 1 പ്ലസ് CK ബൈ CK. സോ വാട്ട് വി ക്യാൻ ഡു, സി യു ജസ്റ്റ് സീ ദിസ് പ്രോബ്ലം. ദിസ് ഈസ് ഇൻ ദ ഫോം ഓഫ് സം എ പ്ലസ് ബി ബൈ സി. സോ ക്യാൻ ഐ സെപ്പറേറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ആസ് എ ബൈ സി പ്ലസ് ബി ബൈ സി? Isn't it? So 1 plus CK by CK, how you can separate? 1 by CK plus CK by CK. What I did is, I separate the denominator. Like, you know, 1 plus CK by CK, I can write it as 1 by CK plus CK by CK. This is the rule I have used here. A plus B by C, we can write it as A by C plus B by C. By using the same rule, I can easily write in this way, isn't it? So you can ask me a doubt, sir, നമുക്കിപ്പം ഈ സി കെക്ക് ഇങ്ങനെ വരും 1/cos എന്നൊക്കെ എഴുതി, ഇതിനൊക്കെ വരും 1/, അങ്ങനെയൊക്കെ ചെയ്യാം. പക്ഷേ നമ്മളെപ്പോഴും ഒരു ട്രിഗണോമെട്രിയിലെ പ്രോബ്ലത്തിൽ ഏറ്റവും സിമ്പിളായിട്ടുള്ള മെത്തേഡാണ് നോക്കുക. അപ്പം ഈ ഒരു പ്രോബ്ലത്തിൽ ഏറ്റവും സിമ്പിളായിട്ടുള്ള മെത്തേഡ് ഇതാണ്. കാരണം ഇങ്ങനെ സെപ്പറേറ്റ് ചെയ്താനുള്ള ഗുണം എന്താണ്? വാട്ട് ഈസ് 1/CK? 1/CK ഈസ് കോസെ. വാട്ട് ഈസ് CK/CK? 1. സോ സി ദ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ സിംപ്ലിഫൈഡ്. So this if you follow this particular step, we will get a simplified answer. And now we just see, when we simplify LHS, we reached cos A plus 1. We didn't reach the RHS side, isn't it? We reached only at cos A plus 1. We didn't reach directly into RHS. That's why they given a hint that you have to simplify LHS and RHS. Why? Because if you simplify LHS, you may fail to reach into RHS. Okay. So I simplified LHS. Then you just take RHS side. What RHS side says? What is that? Sin square a by 1 minus cos a. അപ്പം നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഈ കോസെ പ്ലസ് വണ്ണിയുടെ LHS എത്തിയില്ലേ? ഇതിന് ഇനിയും വേറെ എന്തെങ്കിലുമൊക്കെ ഐഡൻറ്റിറ്റി ഉപയോഗിച്ച് വേണമെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് അങ്ങോട്ട് എത്തിക്കാം. പക്ഷേ അതിനേക്കാൾ എളുപ്പത്തിൽ LHS-നെ RHS-നെ സിംപ്ലിഫൈ ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ അതിനേക്കാൾ എളുപ്പത്തിൽ കിട്ടുമെന്നുള്ളതുകൊണ്ടായിരിക്കും വേറെ ഹിൻഡ് തന്നത്. നമുക്ക് നോക്കാം. ടേക്ക് ദി RHS. വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദാറ്റ്? സൈൻ സ്ക്വയർ എ ബൈ 1 മൈനസ് കോസെ. ആൻഡ് യു ടു സീ ഹിയർ ന്യൂമറേറ്റർ ഇസ് ഇൻ ടേംസ് ഓഫ് സൈൻ സ്ക്വയർ എ and denominator is in terms of cos a. What I am going to do is, can I replace this sin square a by 1 minus cos square a? Can I replace this sin square a by 1 minus cos square a, and denominator as it is 1 minus cos a? What is the reason for I am replacing this sin square a as 1 minus cos square a? By which identity? We know that identity sin square a plus cos square a is equal to 1. From this identity, what we can say? Sin square a is nothing but 1 minus cos square a, no?
So instead of sine square, you can replace 1 minus cos square divided by 1 minus cos A. And instead of this one, can you write 1 square? Can you write 1 square instead of that one? Yes. Now it become in the form A square minus B square. What is A square minus B square? A plus B into what? A minus B. So this one I can separate it as by using A plus B into A minus B. Because this is in the form A square minus B square. A square minus B square is nothing but A plus B into A minus B. And denominator as it is, what is that? 1 minus cos A. Now we just see these two terms get cancelled. What will remain? 1 plus cos A. Now we just see when we simplified LHS, we got 1 plus cos A. When we simplified RHS, we got 1 plus cos A. That means LHS become equal to RHS. So this is the proof for that. Because LHS and RHS are implying the same thing. That means LHS equal to RHS, isn't it? So we can write what? LHS becomes equal to RHS. This is also one way of proving. Okay. And you may understood that what is the reason for writing the sine square as 1 minus cos square. Because when I write 1 minus cos square, in the next step I can write 1 square minus cos square. Then I can use A plus B and A minus B. In that way these two terms, this denominator and this numerator will get cancelled in this way. So these kind of advantages we have to use. Then how we will understood about these kind of advantages? By practicing many, many, many number of problems. So this is the answer for that question. You may understood. Every time when you solve problem, you have to go for the most simple steps. Don't make the question in as a difficult one. Okay. That means in this specific question, if you follow this particular step, we will get the answer very fast. There may exist many, many different methods. You can try that.
Listen. In the previous question, that means the question just now we have discussed, the question just now we have discussed is 1 plus ck divided by ck is equal to sine square a by 1 minus cos a. So LHS simplification is very simple, you may understood. RHS, in order to simplify RHS, one more method is there. I have discussed about the, for a particular question, there may exist many different methods. I will show you one method, another method to simplify RHS. What is RHS? What is RHS? Sine square a by 1 minus cos a. So what we did in the previous method, we replaced sine square a by 1 minus cos square a. So instead of that, what I am going to do is sine square a by 1 minus cos a. No? So what I am going to do is just multiply both numerator and denominator with its conjugate. Here the number is 1 minus cos a. What is the conjugate? 1 plus cos a. Just multiply with 1 plus cos a in the numerator and denominator. When you multiply numerator with 1 plus cos a, it becomes sine square a into 1 plus cos A. When you multiply the denominators, it is in the form A minus B into A plus B. So it become A square minus B square. That means 1 square minus cos square A. Now we just see, it become sine square A by 1 plus cos A. Sorry, sine square A into 1 plus cos A. And this is nothing but 1 square is nothing but 1. What is 1 minus cos square A? 1 minus cos square A is, what is sine square A? By which identity? Identity? Sin square a plus cos square a is equal to 1. Otherwise, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. By using that identity, we can easily say that 1 minus cos square a is nothing but sin square a. So replace 1 minus cos square a sin square a. Then these two get terms will get cancelled. What we will get? 1 plus cos a. You may understood. So you may understood what is the reason for multiplying with its conjugate. Because when I multiply 1 minus cos A with 1 plus cos A, I will get 1 square minus cos square A. I know that 1 minus cos square A is nothing but sin square A. This kind of a replacement is possible in the denominator. That's why I multiplied with the conjugate. Every time we cannot multiply with the conjugate. Every time we cannot multiply with its conjugate. But sometime we can multiply with its conjugate if it creates any benefit. See, it creates a benefit because this type of a cancellation possible. Are you following me? Okay. See, now we have solved question number 4, I think. Yes, question number 4. And actually, we heard about question number 5 just now. But question number 5 is a little more time need to explain question number 5. So I am going to leave that question number 5 and I will explain that question number 5 in the very next video because it needs some time. I have to reduce the time in this video. Okay, that's why I'm doing like this. So let me take question number 6 now. Okay, go for question number 6. Now we can leave question number 5. I'll explain you later. Question number 6 now.
So this is your question now. Square root of, we have to prove that square root of 1 plus sin a divided by 1 minus sin a is equal to ck plus 1 a. So let me start from LHS. So what LHS says, square root of 1 plus sin a divided by 1 minus sin a. You just see what we can do now. See, what I'm going to do in this particular question is, what is the denominator here? 1 minus sin a, no? See, let me remind you one thing here. Ratios are sine a. This is most simplified form. It is not like ck or cot a. If it is cot a, we can replace by cos a by sine a. Or if it is ck, we can try to replace, we can try just replacing by 1 by cos a and all. But here it is most simplified ratios. So what I'm, which method I'm going to use is, see the denominator 1 minus sine a. So I'm going to multiply both numerator and denominator with its conjugate. Here the denominator is 1 minus sine a. If I take the conjugate, it become 1 plus sine a. So by using 1 plus sine a, I'm going to multiply both numerator and denominator under the square root itself. So just make the length of the square root with sufficient length, and the question is 1 plus sin a divided by 1 minus sin a, and I am going to multiply both numerator and denominator with 1 plus sin a with its conjugate, because I know that it will create benefits. That's why I am doing like this. And you know, when you multiply 1 plus sin a with 1 plus sin a, it become 1 plus sin a whole square. When you multiply 1 minus sin a with 1 plus sin a, it become in the form a minus b into a plus b. So a square minus b square, that's why that means 1 square minus sin square a. And you just see now under the square root, 1 plus sin a whole square divided by, what is 1 square? 1. So it become 1 minus sin square a. What is 1 minus sin square a? Cos square, you know, by which identity? Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So apply square root separately. You just try to apply square root separately. When you apply square root for numerator, numerator is 1 plus sin a whole square. When you apply square root, it become 1 plus sin a, because square root of x square is x. And what is the square root of cos square? It become cos a. Now you just separate the denominator. Why? How you can separate the denominator? 1 by cos a plus sin a by cos a. What is 1 by cos a? 1 by cos a is ck, no? What is sin a by cos a? Tan a, no? So we successfully reached in RHS. Separate the denominator. 1 plus sin a by cos a become 1 by cos a plus sin a by cos a. 1 by cos a is ck, sin a by cos a is tan a. See, we have reached in RHS. So this is how that particular question can be solved out. And there may exist many different methods. Okay. As I told you, for each question there may exist many different ways of solution. Then how we will come to know about these many different ways of solution? You have to try. Otherwise, if you are trying is fail, suppose that try may fail, so at that time you just try to google the same question. Okay, type the same question and in the Google, in the search bar, then we will get plenty of solution solving method. Okay, in that way, you have to, if it is possible, you just try to set a research on this topic by googling. Then we will get many different kinds of solution. Okay, and you can choose the best way of solution. I will not say you have to follow the same method what I am teaching. You have to try for many different ways of solution. Okay, so just go for the very next question. See, now we just see. We have to prove that sin theta minus 2 sin cube theta divided by 2 cos cube theta minus cos theta is equal to tan theta, just tan theta. So let us start from LHS as always. And LHS is nothing but sin theta minus 2 sin cube theta divided by 2 cos cube theta minus cos theta. And now we just see the numerator and denominator. It is contains only the simple ratio sin cos, isn't it? But numerator you can take a sin outside. And denominator also you can take cos outside. So if you take sin theta outside from the numerator, because sin theta is common in both them, here cos theta is common in both them. So sin theta I'm going to take common from the numerator, cos theta I'm going to take common from the denominator. If you take sin theta from numerator outside, and if you take cos theta from denominator outside, so sin theta if I'm going to take from numerator, here nothing will remain, so you write 1. Here 2 will remain, and sin cube theta, 1 sin theta came outside, so sin square theta will remain. So similarly in the denominator, see, in the denominator if you take cos theta outside, 2 cos square theta minus 1 will remain, isn't it? Okay, and now we just see, what is sin theta by cos theta? What is sin theta by cos theta? Tan theta, isn't it? And what is remaining? 1 minus 2 sin square theta divided by 2 cos square theta minus 1 will remain. because sin theta by cos theta become tan theta, and this term, these two terms as it is will remain. Now you see, and now you just focus on the RHS side. RHS we have to prove that RHS we have to show that into tan theta. Now we reached here, tan theta into something. We just need tan theta only, because RHS is, we have to prove that the entire LHS is equal to RHS. And RHS is nothing but tan theta. We reached as tan theta into something. That means, suppose if you can prove this as 1, then tan theta into 1 become tan theta, no? So, in short, in order to reach in the RHS tan theta, we have to mention, we have to prove that this is equal to 1. Why? Because we already got tan theta into this much. If this much is become 1, it become tan theta into 1. Tan theta into 1 is nothing but tan theta. In that way, we can reach into RHS. No. That means, in short, we have to prove this as 1. How we can prove this as 1? We have to go for more simplification process. That means, tan theta as it is, we are not going to disturb it because we need that. And 1 minus 2, this sine square, 1 minus 2 sine square theta as it is. And instead of 2 cos square theta minus 1, I am going to write 2 as it is. Instead of cos square theta, can I write 1 minus sin square theta? Any problem? And minus 1 as it is. See? Why? Because cos square theta is nothing but 1 minus sin square theta. By which identity? Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. From that identity, we derived an expression for cos square theta as 1 minus sin square theta. So instead of cos square theta, I can replace by 1 minus sin square theta. You can ask me why. In the very next step, you will get understood. And now you just see it become tan theta into numerator 1 minus 2 sin square theta divided by denominator, you can take this 2 inside. So it becomes 2 minus 2 sin square theta minus 1. You know, you just see the denominator. Now, what is 2 minus 1? What is 2 minus 1? 1. Isn't it? So very next step, I can write that tan theta into numerator 1 minus 2 sin square theta as it is. And 2 minus 1 is 1. What will remain? Minus 2 sin square theta will remain. Now you just see. Can cancel both time, no? So tan theta into 1 is nothing but tan theta. This is how this problem can be solved out. See. While seeing a question, you may think that that question is difficult, but that question is not difficult. See, we reached into the answer very fast. We got tan theta. So, you may understood this 3 question. And comparatively, this 3 question is very simple, isn't it? As we when we compare to the little difficult question in this chapter, this question is very simple, very easy way we can solve out. So please learn the video well. Even though the question is very simple, you have to spend an amount of energy in this session. Please learn the video well and practice the same question twice, and practice more question. The coming question you can just practice, okay? And wish you a good learning. Thank you.